Hi guys, my name is Stan, and today the video is about the update function, which has been introduced starting from Multilogin 3.0 Rise. If you have not yet downloaded the 3.0 version, when you open the 3.0 on existing account where you have existing browser profiles, instead of the start button, you will see the update. And if you try to click on it, it will basically tell you that this function will update the fingerprint of your browser. And probably when you saw this, the very first question you get is, why should I update and why is this needed? In order to answer this question, we need to first understand how website can retrieve the version of your browser that you're using. And essentially, how the website can do is by using two methods. The first method is by reading the information in your user agent. So every user agent consists of information of what your browser is, what operating system you're running, and the version of your browser. The second way how website can understand what version of the browser you're using is by checking the navigator tree structure. In every browser version, there are slightly different navigator object and navigator APIs which the website can use to interact with the browser. So essentially, Chrome 63 and Chrome 67 will have slightly different navigator objects in the navigator tree. So essentially, that's two ways. Now slowly transitioning into the question of why the update is needed. Let's imagine we do not update the browser. If we launch the browser profile, which was created on 2.x, the website will see that, for example, your version of Chrome is 63. However, it is launched on an engine of Chromium 67. 67 has different navigator tree structure, and the browser profile is telling the website that it's 63. And there's going to be a discrepancy, a possible discrepancy that website can check. The thing is, why is it such an important thing is that websites basically check the navigator tree structure as one of the first steps in analyzing the browser fingerprints. So it is almost as important as the IP address. This is why we have this update. We'll essentially update the browser profile to be compatible with the new core browser versions which were introduced in 3.0. Along with the user agent, it will slightly alter other navigator object parameters in order to be compatible with the new core browser versions. It will do this in a way that all the parameters will stay consistent, and it will essentially emulate a browser update. Websites will see it as a normal browser update. Of course, changing any fingerprint parameter to existing browser profile, a thing you need to do with a precaution. You need to be very cautious updating this and testing first and seeing how your website, where you're specifically working at, will behave. So we very highly recommend that you take a browser profile or take an account which you don't care too much about, update it and open it and see how the website will react. I do want to point out that there are also quite a lot of benefits updating the browser profile, because it will essentially emulate a browser update. And browser updates are very common within the normal distribution of users. So all normal users update their browsers because it's normal. Typically, when you download Chrome and Firefox, the option of auto update is always on. So it's a very normal behavior. And it can be argued that not updating the browser, not showing the website that you have updated your browser can be even more suspicious than updating. So not updating can be even more suspicious than updating the browser. And so yeah, that's pretty much it. Also, we are releasing 3.0 as a portable version. This means that you can launch Multilogin 3.0 in parallel with 2.3.2, 2.1.4, or any other version that you have. And you can essentially open different versions in parallel and work there. So you could new browser profiles on 3.0 and continue using your remaining ones on the 2.3.2. I do want to finally point out that browser profiles created on 3.0, it will not be possible to open them on lower versions due to the fact that the drivers are incompatible. That's pretty much it. Thanks very much for watching, guys. Again, don't forget to subscribe to our Telegram channel, where we post these videos, important updates and some cool stuff as well. There you can find a lot of useful information for your work and how to work with Multilogin. Thanks very much for watching, guys. I hope this video was useful to you. Bye-bye.